Okay, now, for example, moving back a little bit. All right, let's say we had a play like Duo. Now let me show you what Duo is. Duo is a good play versus an under defense or a 3-4. So any of you guys out there that see an under or a 3-4 defense, I'll draw the picture on both sides, okay? I've got a defensive end somewhere, I've got a Sam backer, I've got a nose guard, and I got a Mike, all right? And I'll call that a jack, an end and a will. I got 3-4 personnel, you know, three down linemen, four linebackers. All right, let's go to an under defense, okay? Now I got a tilted nose, I got an end, I got a Sam, I got a Mike, I got a tackle, I got a will, I got an end, right? All right, now let's talk about the play duo. All right, on the play duo, first of all, here's what the responsibility is, particularly against these defenses. The fullback or the lead back, he kicks out the Sam, okay? So that's another discussion on its own, but let's figure this guy's eliminated with a kickout block. He's eliminated with a kickout block, right? Here's a good play if you don't want to teach guards pulling and so forth. These two guys double team the five technique, and the tight end gets close to him, to the Mike. These two guys double team the nose to the jack, and these two guys turn back on the backside. You see those two double teams versus that defense? Now a wide receiver's got to be able to block the strong safety. We call that duo. Let's draw it against an under defense. Really the same thing here. We're double teaming to that guy. We're double teaming to that guy. These two guys are one-on-one. Fullback kicks out. Now on that particular play, the running back just opens, shoulders are square, and he runs right at the butt of the guard downhill as fast as he can. Well, as fast as he can. He's not trying to slow it up. He's not trying to drop step opposite. And he reads this linebacker. He reads that linebacker. If that linebacker stays in, he bounces the ball outside. If that backer scrapes off, he keeps the ball up in the hole. You're getting two double teams. The point I'm getting on is the same thing would occur here. If these guys are dropping to a knee, the guy that gets underneath them can turn them back outside, right? If they're just in the gap, we take them north with the post guy using the lazy forearm. Remember, the post guy using the lazy forearm, the other guy using the double under. Okay, if they're more on the guy, this guy twists them and he shoves them with a high leg and comes off. So that's kind of an example of a play where you'd get your two double teams.